Hi friends, welcome to the channel Dinas. Here we are discussing about Jipmer Clerical Nursing Exam Provisional Answer Key. The exam was conducted on 7th March 2020. Here is the provisional answer key. The official answer key not yet published. For that, you need to visit Jipmer Clerical official website. So question starts now. Before that, if you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. First question, when analyzing the serum laboratory report for a client diagnosed with the lung cancer that has metastasized to pelvic bone, which finding should the nurse anticipate? Elevated calcium, decreased hemoglobin, elevated serum creatinine, elevated creatine kinase. Correct answer, elevated calcium. Malignant tumors cause hypercalcemia through a variety of mechanisms, one being an increased release of calcium from the bones. Malignant tumors cause hypercalcemia through a variety of mechanisms, one being an increased release of calcium from the bones. Next question. Primary care providers orders that the client having a client have an elastic bandage applied to the lower extremity to reduce edema. At which position on the client's leg should the nurse start wrapping the elastic bandage? Here correct answer is location D, that is from foot. The elastic bandage will start from foot and end up to knee. Next question, which priority nursing diagnosis should a nurse document in plan of care for a patient client following a C5 C6 anterior cervical discectomy? Potential ineffective breathing pattern, potential impaired tissue perfusion, risk for infection, impaired skin integrity. Correct answer is potential ineffective breathing pattern. Next question. A homeless client visiting a health clinic is noted to have a smooth and reddened tongue and ulcers at the corners of the mouth. The client was tentatively diagnosed with a hematological disorder and laboratory tests were prescribed. Based on the information, a nurse should expect the client's laboratory result to reveal low hemoglobin, elevated red RBCs, prolonged prothrombin times, low WBCs. Correct answer, low hemoglobin level. A smooth red tongue, ulcers at the corners of the mouth, that is angular keloses, and a low hemoglobin are signs of iron deficiency anemia. Next question. 1 month after discharge, a client who had a left total hip replacement calls a clinic reporting acute constant pain in the left groin and hip area and feeling like the left leg is shorter than the right. A nurse advises the client to come to the clinic immediately suspecting wound infection, deep vein thrombosis, dislocation of processes, aseptic loosening of the processes. Correct answer, dislocation of the processes. Next question. Which assessment should a nurse perform to obtain the most accurate determination of fluid balance for a child with hydronephrosis? Measuring the client's intake and output, weighing the client, assessing the presence of edema, evaluating serum electrolyte results. Correct answer, weighing the client. Weight is the most accurate. Intake and output provides data, but there is an additional fluid loss through skin, lungs and the gastrointestinal tract cannot be measured. Edema is an indication of fluid retention but is not accurate. That is why weight is considered as most accurate for hydronephrosis. Next question. The family of a client who is scheduled for emergency surgery following an accident as if they can donate blood for the client. The client's blood type is B negative. A nurse informs the family that packed red blood cells could likely to be used from family members whose blood type is type A positive, type B positive, type B negative, type O positive. Correct answer, type B negative. Next question. A nurse teaches a co-worker that the treatment for hemophilia will likely include periodic self-administration of platelets, whole blood, factor concentrate, fresh frozen plasma. Correct answer, factor concentrate. A person with hemophilia A is deficient in factor 8, hemophilia B is deficient in factor 9. Recombinant form of the factors are available for the client to self-administer intravenously at home. Next question. A nurse has reviewed the upper arm blood pressure results for multiple children between the ages of 3 and 5. Which BP reading should the nurse evaluate as being an abnormal BP for the age group? 96 by 42 mm of mercury, 101 by 57 mm of mercury, 112 by 66, 115 by 68 mm of mercury. Here correct answer is 96 by 42 mm of mercury. Here diastolic pressure 42 is below the normal level, so it is considered abnormal BP of this age group. Next question. A nurse is performing hourly neurological assessment checks on a client who is admitted with changes in mental status. The nurse understands that frequent assessments are used to determine if a client is developing increased intracranial pressure. Which option correctly describes the outcome? Displacement of brain tissue, increased in cerebral circulation and perfusion, increase in serum pH, improved brain tissue oxygenation. Here correct answer is displacement of brain tissue. Next question. Following an industrial accident in which a client sustained a severe craniocerebral trauma, the client develops complication of diabetes insipidus. A nurse suspects this complication is occurring when observing which symptom? Hyperglycemia, large amount of urinary output, elevated urine specific gravity, decrease in level of consciousness. Correct answer is large amount of urine output, that is polyuria. Diabetes insipidus is associated with decreased production of or secretion of antidiuretic hormone. This causes increased urine output and increased plasma osmolality. Next question. A nurse is analyzing serum laboratory results for a 73-year-old female client scheduled for surgery in a 2-hour. The nurse concludes that which results would warrant the most immediate notification of the physician? Hemoglobin 10 gram per deciliter, creatinine 1 milligram per deciliter, potassium 4.0 milliequivalent per deciliter, prothrombin time 22 seconds. Correct answer, prothrombin time 22 seconds, that is increased. Normal prothrombin time is 12 to 14 seconds. So prothrombin time is 22 indicates there is a problem in blood coagulation, which may lead to increased bleeding during surgery. Next question. Nurse is caring for a pediatric client who has congestive heart failure. The client is receiving digoxin therapy. Which laboratory test result is most important to evaluate when preparing to administer digoxin? Serum potassium level, serum magnesium level, serum sodium level, serum chloride levels. Correct answer, serum potassium level. One of the complications of digoxin therapy is hypokalemia, so serum potassium level is very important. Next question. A client is scheduled for an outpatient electroencephalogram. A nurse instructs the clients to prepare for the test by removing all hairpins, avoiding eating or drinking at least 6 hours prior to the test, being prepared to have some of the scalp shaved, having blood drawn for glucose level 2 hours before EEG. Correct answer, removing all hairpins. In an EEG, electrodes are placed on the scalp over multiple areas of the brain to detect and record patterns of electrical activity. Preparation include clean hair with shampoo without any object in the hair to prevent inaccurate test results. Next question. A client is admitted to intensive care unit because of a leaky cerebral aneurysm. A family member asks why the client is awakened and questioned about his orientation so frequently when he need to rest. The nurse answers the family member based on the knowledge that the earliest sign of ICP is. pupillary changes, drop in blood pressure, altered sensation, changes in level of consciousness. Correct answer, changes in level of consciousness. Early sign of increased ICP is changes in level of consciousness. Next question. A client is admitted to hospital with a diagnosis of acute pyelonephritis. Which symptom occurs most frequently and should be monitored by the nurse? Low-grade fever, bradycardia, flank pain on the affected side, rebound tenderness in left lower quadrant. Correct answer is flank pain on the affected side. Next question. A nurse is assessing a blood pressure of an adult client with a manual sphygmomanometer. The nurse places the bell of the diaphragm of telescope over the brachial artery and pumps the cuff up to 180 mm of mercury. The valve is released to allow a drop of 2 mm per mercury per second. At 162 mm of mercury, the nurse hears the first tapping sound. The sound becomes muffled at 148 mm mercury. The sound changes to soft thumping at the 138 mm of mercury. The sound fades to muffled blowing sound to 128 mm of mercury and is last heard at 94 mm of mercury. There is silence at 92 mm of mercury. The nurse should document the blood pressure as 138 by 92, 148 by 94, 162 by 92, 162 by 94. Here the correct answer is 162 by 94. The question is asked regarding how to take BP. So the question become very bigger. Next question. A client with a diagnosis of Guillain-Barré syndrome is scheduled to receive plasmapheresis treatment. A nurse explains to client spouse that the purpose of plasmapheresis is to remove excess fluid from the bloodstream, restore protein levels in the blood, remove circulating antibodies in the blood. Correct answer is remove circulating antibodies in the blood. Next question. A nurse is caring for a client who received conscious sedation during a surgical procedure. Which assessment of the client is most important for a nurse to make postoperatively? Lung sounds, amount of urine output, ability to swallow liquids, rate and depth of breathing. Here correct answer is rate and depth of breathing. Moderate sedation or conscious sedation is used routinely for procedures that do not require complete anesthesia, but rather a depressed level of consciousness. So, respiratory monitoring is important in moderate sedation or conscious sedation. Next question. A 39-year-old client presents in active labor. The client is breathing rapidly and having difficulty coping with the contraction. Based on this assessment, what would the nurse predict should occur if interventions are not initiated immediately? Respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, metabolic acidosis. Correct answer, respiratory alkalosis. Because of the breathing rapidly, the carbon dioxide from the lungs will remove easily. So, there is a chance to get respiratory alkalosis. Next question. A nurse evaluates the drainage from the client's nasogastric tube inserted for gastric decompression during emergency surgery would be normal if it returns brown liquid in color, returns greenish yellow in color, has an alkalotic hydrogen level, measures less than 25 ml per volume. Correct answer, returns greenish yellow in color, that is color of bile. Next question. A client who has had a stroke stares at a nurse but does not attempt to verbally respond to the nurse's questions. The client follows instruction without any problem. The nurse understands that the client is displaying symptoms consistent with. रिसेप्टिव अफेसिया, ग्लोबल अफेसिया, एक्सप्रेसिव अफेसिया, बोथ रिसेप्टिव एंड एक्सप्रेसिव अफेसिया। हियर करेक्ट आंसर इज एक्सप्रेसिव अफेसिया। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ए नर्स नोटिफाइज ए फिजिशियन आफ्टर असेसिंग ए क्लाइंट्स 5 days after an exploratory laparotomy and noting a distended abdomen, abdominal pain, absence of flatus and absent bowel sounds. Which typical complication of abdomen surgery should the nurse conclude may be occurring? Paralytic ileus, peritonitis, wound dehiscence. Correct answer is paralytic ileus. Next question, various children are being seen in the clinic for well baby checks. By what age should the nurse expect a child to begin to use simple words to communicate needs? Age 10 to 12 months, age 1 to 2 years, age 6 to 9 months, age 2 to 3 years. Correct answer, age 10 to 12 months. The baby will start simple words to communicate at the age of 10 to 12 months. Next question, which result should a nurse expect if a 4-year-old child visual acuity test is normal for a child's developmental age? Which result should a nurse expect if a 4-year-old child's visual acuity test is normal for the child's developmental age? 10 by 10, 20 by 20, 20 by 40, 40 by 40. The correct answer is 20 by 20. At the year of 4 age, the visual acuity will be 20 by 20. That is normal vision. Next question, which assessment finding should a nurse expect following administration of phenylephrine eye drops to perform an ophthalmic eye examination? Tremor, hypotension, pupil meiosis, pupil midriasis. Correct answer is pupil midriasis, that means pupil will dilate after instilling phenylephrine eye drops. Pupil will dilate. Next question, a client presents with meningioma and symptoms of increased intracranial pressure. Which manifestation should the nurse least expect to find on assessment of the client? Headache, vomiting, pyrexia, papal edema. Correct answer, pyrexia or fever. Next question, an experienced nurse explains to a new nurse that the definitive diagnosis of peptic ulcers involves. An experienced nurse explains to a new nurse that the definitive diagnosis of peptic ulcer disease involves a urea breath test, upper gastrointestinal endoscopy with the biopsy, barium quota studies, the string test. Correct answer, upper gastrointestinal endoscopy with the biopsy. That is the definitive diagnosis for peptic ulcer disease. A urea breath test indicates that presence of Helicobacter pylori, but definitive diagnostic measure is gastrointestinal endoscopy with biopsy. Next question, a clinic nurse is administering monovalent hepatitis B vaccine intramuscularly to a newborn prior to hospital discharge. Which site is best for the nurse to plan to administer the injection? Deltoid, ventrogluteal, dorsogluteal, vastus lateralis. For a newborn baby, vastus lateralis is the site of IM injection. Next question. After a car or pedestrian accident, a pedestrian client is brought to the emergency room. The client is alert and oriented but complains of dyspnea. Oxygen saturation levels vary from 88 to 90 degree, 90%. Oxygen is applied at 2 liter per nasal cannula with no improvement in SpO2. Oxygen per mask is initiated at 40% with little improvement. Radiograph films reveals no obvious injury or fractures. Suddenly the client loses consciousness as a respiratory arrest and subsequently dies. During the respiratory arrest situation, it is determined that a nurse failed to open the valve to the oxygen tank and the client had not been receiving oxygen. What is the key ethical principle involved in this situation? Correct answer, non-maleficence, fidelity, beneficence, justice. Here correct answer is non-maleficence. Correct. Next question. Which lobe is responsible for feeling and touch? Feeling of touch. Frontal, parietal, occipital, temporal. Correct answer is parietal lobe. Next question. A clinic nurse is planning to assess the lymph node for a client with suspected Hodgkin's lymphoma, starting at the location where the disease usually begins. On the illustration below, at which area should the nurse plan to begin the examination? Correct answer, location A, that is cervical and neck lymph nodes. The Hodgkin's lymphoma will start from cervical and neck lymph nodes. Next question. A client with diabetes mellitus is being taught to self-administer subcutaneous injection of insulin. Identify the preferred site of the self-administration of this drug. Here correct answer is option D, that is around the umbilicus. Around the umbilicus is self-administration area of insulin. Next question. A male client who is considering a vasectomy for contraception asks nurse where the incision of the procedure will be made. The nurse utilizes the picture below to educate the client on which area of the body should the nurse inform the client that the incision will most likely to be made. Here correct option is option B. Next question. A client involved in a work-related accident is scheduled for surgery to repair a comminuted femur fracture. 3 days following surgery, the client asks nurse to describe what is meant by a comminuted femur fracture. In describing the fracture, which illustration should the nurse show the client? Here correct answer is option B, that is a example of comminuted fracture, that is fracture of the bone with fragments. That is the example of comminuted fracture. So questions ends here. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe our channel, The Nurse. Thank you.